السلام عليكم. My name Muhammad Azrin Amir bin Zakaria. Today in 30 minute lesson, I will share with you about the second law of thermodynamics. The second law of thermodynamics is contained about 5 subtopics. This is heat engine, energy conversion, efficiency, refrigerators and heat pumps, reversible and irreversible processes, Carnot cycle and device. Okay, in second law of thermodynamics, we can establish the direction for processes, provide a mean for measuring the quality of energy, establish theoretical limits on performance for engineering device, establish condition for equilibrium. Okay. Second law of thermodynamics. As I said before, the second law of thermodynamics is establish condition for equilibrium. For example, the process occur in a certain direction, not in any direction. For example, we have some material here, different material, and part A, material A, part B as a material B. Okay. They have a different temperature, such as at the part B will be 40 degrees and at part A about 10 degrees Celsius. Okay. When the equilibrium occur in thermodynamics, the highest temperature will move to the lower temperature. Okay. So at the part B will move to the part A, and it will be the same temperature as 20 degrees Celsius. Okay. Okay, we move on a second law of thermodynamics. Okay. Heat sink. Heat sink is reservoir that absorb heat. There's a condenser. We'll pump the heat and energy sink. Okay. For the heat source, the river that supplies heat. Of the second law of thermodynamics. This is what heat engine. Okay. Heat engine is any device that converts heat energy into useful work. Okay. It's about as condenser here to be the heat out and pump. Okay, the high temperature heat here at the high. Okay. In the high, here is low heat temperature disable. Okay. Will be Q1, Q in, and then Q out, the lift will. Okay. Or we can do the characteristic of heat engine. There's a receive heat from a high temperature source. They convert part of this heat to work. They reject the remaining waste heat to a lower temperature sink. They operate on a cycle. That's a mean here we move to the lower temperature. Here is a high temperature. We move to the lower temperature and we will get the work Q in and Q out. Okay, so we can find here as a formula is W equal to Q in minus Q out. Okay. We move on to the second. This is thermal efficiency. Okay. In thermal efficiency. Let's see. In general, we will get the formula general perform equal to desired output over required input. And for the heat engine, the thermal efficiency, thermal, or we as a symbol here, equal to network output over the total input. Network output over total input. Okay, how will be equal to thermal efficiency equal to work net over total input, that is Q1. Okay. Here, as we know before this, the formula work Q in minus Q out equal to work, right? So we can take this formula and substitute at here, this at thermal efficiency formula will be Q in minus Q out over temperature in. So it will be 1 minus Q out over Q in. Okay? Or you can handle it like 1 minus Q lower over Q high. Okay. Okay. We move to the third, fourth. It's about refrigerator and heat pumps. Refrigerator and heat pumps are a device that absorb heat from the lower temperature medium and reject it to the higher temperature ones. So means this is like different in the heat engine, right? Okay. In the refrigerator and heat pump, here is a lower temperature and here is a high temperature. Yeah. Okay. The refrigerator absorbs here and we release at a high. Okay. As we know, the difference of refrigerator and heat pump is the refrigerator is to maintain the lower temperature. This means the refrigerator is used to cool down at the high temperature surrounding. And the heat pump that is to increase, to transfer heat from the lower temperature to the high temperature. This means the refrigerator and a heat pump, there are two differentiations. For the refrigerator, used to maintain the lower temperature. As I mentioned before, the function of refrigerator is to to maintain the lower temperature, right? In the to maintain the lower temperature, okay. Here, okay. Here is refrigerator. The at the warm environment, and here the what we say cool refrigerator space right here, and here the condenser or the process cycle for being to maintain the cool lower temperature. Okay, here is require input, right? And here is the desired output. Okay. Okay. Next, we move to the coefficient of performance, or we can call that as COP, coefficient of performance. The coefficient of performance, there is, we can call it as COP, right? Okay, COP this mean equal to the desired result, and over the required input, over the required input. Or this mean COP equal to Q over what I have shown you before. It's some sort of the environment to the process cycling, and here is refrigerator. And here is about Q up, here Q in, and this is desired, and this W is desired result, and here is a required input. Oh, sorry, here, and this is here. Okay. Next, about heat pump. Coefficients of performance of heat pumps equal and heat COP of his heat pumps equal to QH Q higher over what net, or it means you have known before this about net is equal to Q higher minus Q lower. Okay. So we can know this the COP for COP for heat pump N equal to the COP of refrigerator is equal to 1 because their formula at the end of the formula is about same. Okay, we move on to the second thing. We move on to the draft at the ideal gas and the fluid flow. Okay. Graph for the ideal gas is like this. Okay, and show you a second for the fluid flow. Here, I will give gas. Here, fluid flow. Okay. In ideal gas, okay, the flow direction of the ideal gas here will be like a cycle. Okay. And what the for the fluid flow show graph down here. Okay, next we move on to the four subtopic is a reversible and irreversible process. Okay. The process of a reversible process is a process that can be reversed without leaving any trace on the surrounding. And for the irreversible process, that is a process that are not reversible. Okay, the process are not reversible. Process reversible. Okay, the reversible process. The definition is the process which can be reversed without affecting the environment. There is a like a hypothetical process where system and surrounding can be restored to the initial state. Okay, for example, like quiestatic Bayes boundary work, quiestatic heat transfer, or reversible for an infinitesimal total T. Okay, reversible heating. Reversible heating. Okay, it's like this. I will show you some other example. Okay. So how many you want? Okay, last the infinity. What a number of count. Okay. The heat. Refrigerator heating. Okay. The heater is here. Each incremental increase of temperature or dT, incremental increase of temperature dT of the heater result is heat transfer, it's mean like Q, to the water and corresponding increase on the water temperature. For sure enough heating, the state of the heater and the water are nearly equilibrium state, and the process is said to be equilibrium process. Okay, the neglect here will be how the analysis of the slow heating process, and the here will be neglect vaporless, and part of here will be the we will assume no heat loss from side and bottom, and here the heater energy is via electricity or gas combustion will be like that. Okay. And here we can find the state of the equilibrium when both two are in the same temperature. Okay. Irreversible process. All real processes are irreversible. Irreversibilities occur due to friction, heat transfer, non-quiestatic expansion or compression. Other of irreversibilities are like a missing of gas, electric resistance, chemical reaction, inelastic deformation. Okay. Definition. Okay, now we move on to last subtopic, that is Carnot cycle. Carnot cycle is reversible. Before this, I have told you more about irreversible, right? Now, in the Carnot cycle, there's more about reversible. A reversible contains temperature, or we say as an isothermal heat addition from a high temperature reservoir, and reservoir adiabatic expansion, and more the reversible contains temperature heat rejection to a lower temperature reservoir, and reversible adiabatic compression to the original state, or we can show you the graph of Carnot cycle will be like this. Here B and here B. Okay, the graph of B will be okay. Scale number like this. The point and here, here, here. Okay. Right. Okay. And here it will be the reversible heat addition. Heat rejection at here, and last reversible work transfer here. Okay. The Carnot cycle. The Carnot cycle is fully reversible cycle. Each process is itself reversible, can be either a work producing cycle or a work consuming cycle, can be operated in either direction, represents an idealization of most power cycles, work producing and work consuming, because it is a reversibility and generality. Key concept and term of Carnot cycle is a reversible isothermal process, reversible adiabatic process, and reversible cycle. Okay. Carnot process, Carnot cycle clockwise cycle for heat engine, and Carnot cycle anti-clockwise of cycle for refrigerator. They have mentioned before, there's a two difference between heat engines and refrigerator, right? Okay, the Carnot and the last is Carnot device. Carnot device is have a three mean there is a Carnot heat engine, Carnot refrigerator, and Carnot heat pump, right? We have learned about heat engine, refrigerator, and heat pump. Okay, Carnot heat engine, PRV, as a formula, thermal coefficients equal to 1 over T lower and 1 minus T lower over T high. Okay, and for the COP, desire over need. Okay, okay, that's all for me. Thank you.